Are you ready for some quantum algorithms? If you gave the last chapter your best effort, you most definitely are. Even if concepts like entangled states, the Born rule, change of basis, or the Hadamard gate are still a little fuzzy, don't worry. When you encounter them today, just open up the 2-qubit chapter and do a search on any of those keywords. The first algorithm is called superdense coding. It's less dramatic than it sounds, but still quite impressive. It tells us that Alice can send Bob a single qubit, remember that's one subatomic particle, across space, and within that unimaginably small state, communicate one of four possible 2-bit messages, 00, 01, 10, or 11. It would take two ordinary bits, each probably consisting of several thousand atoms, to express the same amount of information. Alice and Bob first prepare an entangled Bell state, and each takes one qubit from that state, thus setting up their communication apparatus. As I'll explain, this preliminary act is perfectly valid and does not violate the goal of sending information in a single qubit, which comes later. When Alice is ready, she authors one of the four 2-bit messages. She then runs her entangled qubit, which is her half of the Bell state, through a unary logic gate, the choice of which is determined by the message she wants to send. Next, Alice ships her qubit off to Bob, who will then have the full, still entangled, pair. At that point, Bob measures his bipartite state along the Bell basis. He'll get one of four values, since a measurement always forces a collapse to one of the basis states, and for H2, there are only four of those. As we'll learn in the chapter, the resulting measurement will reveal the message. I'll discuss the entire process and show a circuit that makes use of two unary gates, X and Z, followed by the binary Bell gate, which we saw last week was a combination of C0 and the first-order Hadamard. The second algorithm has the name quantum teleportation, which evokes images of sugar plum science fiction. This time, Alice's goal is to send Bob a complete qubit, which in a way contains a value that represents one of the infinitely many possible superpositions that a state can be in. It's like sending Bob a real number of infinite precision, and Alice does all this by sending only two classical bits. The trick again is to first prepare their communication channel by producing a Bell state, and each taking one of its two component qubits. Next, Alice produces the general state, ket psi, for teleportation. She never sends this ket, though. That's the point of teleportation. She has to get it to Bob without doing that. Instead, she feeds ket psi along with her half of the Bell state into a binary gate. Alice now measures the output of that gate with respect to the Z basis. She'll see one of four classical strings, 00, 01, 10, or 11. Now remember, each of those is an eigenvalue corresponding to the collapse state caused by the measurement. Now let's pause a moment to note that entire process just described is equivalent to measuring Alice's input state along the Bell basis, and that equivalence is given substantial airtime in your reading. Alice then sends her two classical bits to Bob, who uses them to decide how to process his half of the entangled Bell pair. After he does what the message instructs him to do, Bob's done. He has the original qubit, ket psi, in its full glory. Warning, Bob did not measure anything. He put his qubits through a binary gate, but the gate, as always, was unitary. It did no harm. He's got his hands on ket psi after receiving only two measly classical bits. Again, I'll develop the full circuit for quantum teleportation. Before attacking the third algorithm, we'll take a short detour that provides an overview of Boolean functions, reversible logic gates, and leading to quantum oracles. This is a worthy waypoint because all of our remaining algorithms will solve problems surrounding functions of integers. In fact, practically every problem in computer science, from the breaking of encryption to the traversal of a network, can be represented by a function of integers. And in order to study any such function using quantum computation, we must first emulate it with a unitary gate. And that gate is the function's oracle. After that detour, we turn to the last of today's topics, Deutsch's quantum algorithm. It concerns the determination of an unknown function that is promised to be either constant or balanced, terms to be defined in the reading. The subject of the problem might seem absurdly simple. We're given a scrawny Boolean function of a single binary input and asked whether the function is balanced or constant. There are only four possible functions that could be given under such circumstances, and they can be fully unmasked using classical techniques in two easy evaluations of the function. So who needs a quantum solution? Well, we do. We'd like to do it in one evaluation. And doing that with a classical computer, even the most powerful one on Earth, is impossible. A quantum circuit and its algorithm, however, can answer the question in a single query. And the way it does so is by leveraging quantum parallelism, a fancy term that means putting a superposition state through the oracle and thereby evaluating both f of 0 and f of 1 simultaneously. The details call into action some Hadamard gates and a new trick called the phase kickback. It's great fun and a terrific case study for more realistic problems. Actually, the Hadamard gate plays a triple role. First, it's used to construct a superposition state, ket plus, as input into the oracle's A register, giving us quantum parallelism. Second, it's used to set up the phase kickback trick by preparing ket minus as input to the oracle's B register. And third, it's on the oracle's output as a basis change operator to effect a measurement along the non-preferred X basis. This was, as usual, just a summary. The full explanation and justification of all of today's moves is in your reading. The analysis will be a direct application of our spin one-half quantum mechanics and serves to reinforce those concepts in preparation for the real-world algorithms to come later in the course.